The time is right for chemical manufacturers and spray regulatory authorities to reach a better understanding on drift-reducing technologies, according to a research scientist with one of the world's largest chemical companies. Holger Tank, a formulations specialist at Dow AgroSciences, made the comment while taking part in a three-day DRT workshop in Queensland. The workshop was designed to give regulators an opportunity to learn more about Australian research into and development of improved drift reduction.
There's a lot of development going on here in Australia and in New Zealand. The regulatory authority is trying to develop some guidelines on how to evaluate drift reduction technology and how to incorporate that into the buffer zone guidelines and so on. So I think it's the right time for us really to get in now and try to work with the regulators to help them understand the formulation technology that we bring forward so that that can be incorporated as a regulation being worked on. So.
Mandatory no-spray or buffer zones are under review globally, and this was one of the drivers for Dow AgroSciences to include DRT into their new formulations.
Really, some of the biggest challenges were, it has to be very robust. It has to be very robust in the sense that our products have varying use rates, and there'll be different spray volumes that are being used, so it has to work over a wide range of different concentrations. And the other big challenge was all our products are going to be tank mixed. So the robustness in tank mixes was a real challenge for us. So but I believe now we have technologies that are very robust.
Emulsion forming technology is what Dow has gone with. And the first formulation to incorporate the technology is its oldest, 2,4-D.
Yeah, you're right. It's 65 years old. But in the US we have a new trait that Dow AgroScience developed, the Enlist trait, which provides resistance to 2,4-D. So we're planning to launch it in corn and soybeans and cotton in the US and Latin America. And so we wanted to have a new formulation to go along with our trait, but specifically we wanted to overcome some of the potential issues with applying 2,4-D over the top of crops, which is a new use, totally new use for 2,4-D. We wanted to address any potential for drift, and we wanted to build that into the formulation so we always have it when the product is applied. We don't want to rely on tank mix additives and things like that. So that really was the reason why we focused on 2,4-D.
Early proofing of the new formulation was done here at the University of Queensland's Gatton Wind Tunnel. Dow is the first company to launch a formulation with built-in low-drift technology, and the enhanced product is nearing release in the Americas.
Just a few weeks ago, I received the draft label from the US EPA, and the biggest effect really is on the buffer zone. So the draft label shows a 30-foot buffer zone for our product versus 250 feet for generic 2,4-D. So it's a pretty significant improvement and a significant advantage for the growers having a much reduced buffer zone.
Industry working to reduce spray drift and regulators recognising the advances by prescribing buffer zones to reward best practice is what the workshop aimed to foster. And from this scientist's point of view, the time really is right for that to happen.